The journey out from the city to the village takes little more than an hour, during which time the train rattles past a succession of small provincial stations. What these stations might lack in terms of care and attention is more than made up for by the presence of the beautifully dressed station master, who carries out his job with a dignity and an elegant efficiency that is rare to find elsewhere. Leaving the city behind, the nature of recognisable landmarks quickly changes. Gone are the unedifying office buildings and apartment blocks, and the monotonous motorway that ploughed through the forgiving countryside. Instead, the eye becomes tuned to more organic details, to a single tree standing in a field, to a particular rock in a waterfall, or to a bend in the river. And as we draw closer to our destination, these landmarks become further transformed into ones existing only in the imagination. From the station to the village, the distance is not great, and as we cross the bridge and begin to climb through the wood, following this well-trodden village path, we quickly leave all thoughts of the city behind. The walk itself takes a matter of minutes. It is only the journey of the mind that cannot be measured.